So when we say the security has come to the level of managing the problem real time basis to making it more adaptive, making it more integrative, making it more covered, so it should be covering the all the possible nuances that could potentially create problem, contextualized, it should be more situation aware, it should be more platformized. So all of the orchestrated, automated, and also it talks about it should be predictive in nature as well. So this is how the entire defense of security is coming in. And on top of it, what is happening, the people are expecting a lot out of security. People are expecting that it should satisfy, it should be able to cover all the things which is happening. So our infrastructure is becoming more complex and heterogeneous, but we are expecting the security should cover each and every part of that. Our infrastructure is becoming more complex, we are expecting the security should take care of the complexity involved as well. Our infrastructure is becoming more diverse, we are expecting security should be taking care of the diversity because every of the equipment, devices, applications are asking something from security. The volume and scale that we are looking at in terms of this country, especially the kind of volume that we are doing digitization, we are expecting security to match to the volume and scale of transactions we are processing in here and other part of the globe as well. We are making security more visible, we are asking more visibility from security because a lot of things are happening at a ground level underneath what it exactly tells us basically. We are asking security to become more accurate, more disciplined, more productive and more predictable basically. So these are the new attributes basically which we are expecting from cybersecurity space, and these attributes are now defining the way the enterprise security is being discussed in the context basically. And that's why we see a lot of innovation and entrepreneurship happening in cybersecurity space is because of this. So security nowadays requires a lot of innovation engineering, and that's not only the manager. Until now security was like just get a solution, implement and manage the solution. But that's not the security nowadays basically. So enterprise security is more and more factor of innovation engineering. A lot of effort that needs to be put in terms of understanding how things are going, how things are changing, how should we respond. And that response is increasingly becoming part of what kind of new thinking that you bring to the table basically. So this is how the security, and these are the basically attributes that are becoming very important for the security, and that's why entire game of enterprise security has changed in last 2-3 years like quite significantly. And we see a lot of now big bets are being made for security. There is a platform version of security that we talk about. So one platform which is serving millions of the organization, and in that millions of the organization there are millions, multi-millions of the endpoints, and learning from all of that together and then trying to find at a global level, this particular threat is happening at one part of the globe, probably it could hit other part of the globe as well. So that is how the global operational security is coming, and that's where the enterprise security ecosystem is going. And then we have to look at a national level basically. So how do we solve this at an individual organization level and a national level? So that's what basically I would like to conclude with. So we talk about the security then was largely the assurance driven security. We talk about the security now is mostly the real-time management of the problem in terms of all these attributes that we talked about. But now what is happening is, now is more like a response and recovery. The breaches is happening day by day. How do you quickly respond to those breaches is becoming very important part basically. How can you respond timely? How can you recover? How can you make your response and recovery more systematized basically? How can you make it more automated basically? How can you make your security in such a way that you are limiting the damage? How can you bring lot of multidimensional effort to make sure that you recovery fast basically? How can you make security more engaging in terms of the overall remediation actions are basically most effective actions basically? Because once a ransomware attack happens and your disruptive operations are disrupted basically, there are multiple paths the things can go wrong, or there could be multiple paths the things can be brought to the original layer or recovery layer basically. But finding the best out of it is also one of the important part. So it's a becoming big game in terms of the way that you recover from the any compromise which happens basically. And most of the security from now would be how quickly, how easily, how effectively, how you recover from those kind of attacks is becoming very important part, and that particular part is not now confined to the one organization's individual capability basically. You need entire ecosystem for that. So that ecosystem is largely ecosystem that you need to understand the leaders. You create a leaders which can understand these nuances and these complexities and this kind of larger, bigger context as well as the small nuances involved in this one basically. We need to have a lot of collaborations and information sharing between within the organization, across the sector, within the different sectors basically, at a national level, international level as well. we need a lot of this effort to innovation and research in cyber security so that we identify the problem and try to find solutions for that basically. We need to create a market for those new innovations basically, right? And then we need to create an entire innovation ecosystem which can really think about what can do we do to solve, look at the use case, and that use case is solved in a very technical manner so that it can help us to recover or manage the things in very real-time basis basically. So this is one layer. Other layer which is we have deliberating since morning, probably I heard something on, is for that to happen, the national strategy for the security needs to be devised in a way basically, right? So national strategy needs to be put in a place for that. We have been talking about India's national cybersecurity strategy for the last 2 years, we have been deliberating that. But that strategy should look at these kind of challenges that we are facing at the ground level basically. We are talking about how much of policy and regulation basically that we need to devise for this basically, right? So strategy is one part, but you need to have a lot of policy. It's definitely you solve it, but if something goes wrong, how quickly you are, and that's what you have been deliberating since morning, how do you can make a mind that is equipped enough to solve this problem basically. Also the justice ecosystem also equipped enough to solve this problem basically. And then this particular part is so interdependent and a lot of interventions are required from the government side. So government interest matters a lot in the cyber space that we see as of now basically. And then how we make sure that we have the skill and education so that we understand this complexity, diversity, requirement of the challenges and solve that problem so that we have the people to work to solve this kind of challenge we are into basically. So this is an overall larger framework that I just wanted to discuss with you, where exactly we have been seeing the history of a security, where exactly is reached in terms of real-time management challenge, but from now it's largely the ecosystem coming together to work to solve the problem in a very scalable way. That will only happen basically we all work together. A lot of these pieces like a law enforcement, judiciary, prosecutor on one hand basically, then the security manager on the other hand, the national strategy on the other hand, the policy makers, nine ministries, the regulators basically, the CISO leadership, the CIO leadership, business leadership, all them needs to be coming together to solve this problem in a more scalable way and more practical way, efficient way. So that's what the basically that we believe the business of a security or for example security for businesses would be determining in the coming future basically. With this, to this slides, I would like to conclude and probably the panel will take it away from here. Thank you.